I just thought I'd put myself in front of the video camera and have a chat direct to you, because over the last few days I've been reading some media clips off the back of this piece of work that we've recently put out into the public domain for comment. It's called the Constraints Management Strategy. The next line is important, 2013 to 2024. The reason I want to talk to you is because if I read those media clips, you could be given the impression that this document is about turning the rules of water management in the Murray-Darling Basin as we've known them for the last 100 years on their head, throwing away the rule books, in fact, and commencing some rapid change of water management that's going to see towns flooded and a whole lot of people's property rights affected. I'm here to tell you that that's simply not true. If it were true, I wouldn't be doing this job. No one I know in the history of water management would be foolish enough to undertake such an effort, and that is a million miles from what this document is all about. What this document seeks to do is not change anything, not do anything tomorrow, but merely start a conversation really we have to have, based on the work we've done over the last few years, based on all the submissions that communities have made and individuals have made. We know we can manage the system better and smarter. And unless we start somewhere, we're never going to get to a point where we can make some decisions about how to make some changes that are going to be beneficial for everyone. Of course, when you put a document like this into play, people will either want to use it for their own purposes, make their own points and all those sorts of things. That's sort of water politics in Australia and indeed around the world. That's just situation normal. But let me be very clear. This is not a document that suggests that suddenly towns are going to be flooded or individual water use entitlements are going to be changed. That is not the case. They are not the rules under which we're obliged to play. The governments have been very clear about that and have been from day one. All this does, and what this does, is start a conversation to say, governments of the Murray-Darling Basin, if you want to start making some changes to get better use out of the available water, here are some things you probably need to look at. So I commend this document to you. I think it's certainly worth a read, and if you're going to make comments about it or want to have your say, you can just in the modern era, just click onto the website. It's all there, and you can have your say direct, and you can participate in any of the many meetings that we're conducting and have been conducting around the basin over the past months and into the future. It is important that you have your say, because these are fundamentally important issues that go to the implementation of the plan. But it's not for tomorrow. It's a time thing that's going to be implemented by the basin governments based on their request and only under their direction, calmly, sensibly, in a measured way, to make sure that whenever we use water, that we're doing so with an eye on making that water use the most efficiently possibly can.